order to get Fantastical's more advanced calendar features, you're going to need to connect your calendar account. This can get a little confusing because on the Mac, the only way to get your iCloud account is to add it directly, like I'm going to show you in this video. There's no built-in event kit support on the Mac. However, over on the iPhone and iPad, you can use the built-in event kit iOS support, but adding your account directly on those devices gives you the bonus premium features. So I recommend if you're a premium subscriber, you jump through the hoops in this video and connect your iCloud account on all of your devices. It's totally worth it for those premium features. So let's get started. Going to the Fantastical preferences and clicking on the accounts tab shows this screen. And you can see I've got the Flexibits account connected. And you can also see that it sees the local calendar database and reminders database. But once again, this isn't enough. If I want to get all that juicy goodness out of Fantastical, I need to connect my iCloud account. To do that, you tap on the plus button in the lower left corner of the screen. Then you get this screen showing all of the possible services Fantastical can connect with to manage your calendars. iCloud's at the top of the list. Once I click on that, then it's going to prompt me to put in my iCloud ID and a special one-time use password just for this service. This one-time use password is a security feature that Apple has implemented. I can't use my regular iCloud password for this. I need Apple to generate one for me. So now we'll need to go over to the internet, specifically appleid.apple.com. This is the website at appleid.apple.com. There's a few steps for you to sign in, including a likely separate verification from Apple. But once you're signed in, you're going to see your Apple ID details on a screen like this. The feature we're looking for is under the security pane, specifically the app-specific passwords. If you tap or click on Generate Password, then you're going to get this screen that lets you type in the name of the application for which you're seeking a new password. Once you do that, then the system will give you a one-time use password just for that application. This is a nice security feature from Apple. It means that app developers don't get your iCloud password. So now that you've got this one-time use password, you'll go back over to Fantastical and back to the account settings. Now you can add that iCloud account again, adding your account name and pasting in that one-time use password from the website, and then you're good to go. Once you've completed this, you've got an iCloud synchronization, and that's what you need to get the benefit of many of the features that I discuss throughout this video series. Here I am in Fantastical on the iPhone. I'm going to go to Settings and then Accounts, and you can see I've already set up my account. But if you needed to add it in the iPhone, you just tap Add Account in iCloud, and then you get the same options to put in your Apple ID and your app-specific password. And you obtain the app-specific password exactly the same way at appleid.apple.com. If watching any of the videos in this series, you don't see the feature that I'm discussing, that's probably because you haven't connected iCloud to Fantastical on that device. Just follow the steps in this video and you'll be all set.